Good morning. This is Pastor Zach with the Goodland United Methodist Church with your morning devotion for Wednesday, August 8th. Today I'll be reading from Galatians chapter 5, starting in verse 13. For you were called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. If, however, you bite and devour one another, take care that you are not consumed by one another. A reflection on this passage in Galatians called Loving Our Neighbors by Martin Luther. After having heard and accepted the true teaching about faith, the Apostle Paul seriously admonishes Christians to practice genuine good works. This is because remnants of sin remain in those who are justified. These remnants resist faith and divert us from doing true good works. Human reason and the sinful nature resist the Spirit in believers and control unbelievers. Reason is naturally inclined toward hypocritical superstition. It wants to measure God according to its own thoughts rather than according to His Word. It does work of its own choosing more enthusiastically than the ones God commanded. That's why faithful teachers must teach and impress on people true love and true good works just as much as they teach faith. No one should think they fully understand this command, love your neighbor. Certainly this command is very short and very easy as far as the words are concerned. But where are the teachers and learners who actually practice this in life? These words, serve one another humbly in love, and love your neighbor as yourself, are eternal words. No one can think about, urge, and practice them enough. It's remarkable that believers will immediately have troubled consciousness if they fail to do something trivial. But these same people feel nothing at all when they neglect love and when their hearts aren't sincere and affectionate toward their neighbor. Unfortunately, this happens every day, for they don't regard God's command to love as highly as their own superstitions. The line that he shares towards the end of that says, no one can think about, urge, and practice them enough. The command is to serve one another humbly in love and to love your neighbor as yourself. That command shows up time and time again in the New Testament and is taken straight from the Old Testament. Christ came to imprint that on us, that we are to love God and love our neighbor, that we cannot practice it enough. Sure, the words are simple and we hear them over and over again, but we can practice them and are urged to keep doing it because in God there's never enough of loving our neighbors. Have a blessed day.